Hello folks, my name is Jim and today I'm going to show you the SEO GPT tool and how you can utilize it to make the most of it to optimize content for your website. Now the two most popular content types that are used on SEO GPT are titles and descriptions. And today we're going to specifically take a look at descriptions because we've gotten some feedback that some people are having a little bit of trouble trying to create the best content they can with descriptions. So today we're going to go over that and show you how to do it. So first thing we're going to do is we're on the main SEO GPT page over in the content types. We're going to type in description and we're just going to select the first one. This is just going to be a general description. There are other choices for descriptions, but this is the one that we're going to be testing with today. So under the SEO GPT content builder, you have all these different options, and you don't necessarily have to use all of them. But today we're going to go over how you can utilize these to create better content. The example that we're going to use today is children's books. So here in the keyword phrase, let's just say that you don't really know anything about SEO. You're not an expert, but you want to try to utilize this to create content for you. And the thing you have to kind of ask yourself is, what is the content for, or what's the relevance of the content so that it can then help you to determine what are the keywords and the phrases that you really require to put into the SEO GPT tool in order to get the best output possible. Just to give us an idea of what this looks like, I'm just going to enter in children's books because that's very general. That's something that is not really anything specific about any specific type of children's books. It's just children's books, and let's just see what it writes. So I'm not going to enter in anything else, no target URL, and you can see the content that's written over here. It says a riveting story about overcoming obstacles to achieve a dream and join the adventure of two young children in this captivating tale full of imaginative twists and turns. So It's very general, it's very broad, and that may not be what we're looking for. So how do we get something to be a little bit more specific or more towards what we want? We can come up here over to write again, and we may have to think about enhancing what it is that we want to be able to write. So one thing we can do is, instead of just only playing around with this, we can go over to the keyword tool. And over in the keyword tool, we can put in that same word, children's books, and I just copied it over here. And for in this instance, we're just going to use the default long tail keyword. We're going to look at perhaps five different variations just to give us some ideas if we don't know our ideas yet. If we do, then we can also enter them here. Okay. This has no limit other than that it can't be too long. But you can have multiple keywords, so you can actually separate keywords by commas if you wanted to give the system a more descriptive keyword phrase. But let's just say we didn't know that, and so we just put in children's books, and we're going to tell it to write it and tell it to give us five different variations. So when we do that, you can see that it's come up with several examples, several ideas that we can use. And if we don't like these ideas, if this is not the direction that we're going for, then what we can do is we can tell it to write again. And here we're going to write it again. So without changing anything at all, without changing any settings, we're going to tell it to write it again. And perhaps there is something here that we're really going for, like let's say effective techniques for children's books. So this is going to be something a little bit more narrowed down that's going to help us create better content. So we can take that, we can actually copy that over and go back to where we had our description, which was on web page. So we can go over here, go back to description, put in the keyword that is of interest to us, and we can tell it to write it again. Okay, there it goes. So now it's written something that's a little bit more specific, a little bit more well-defined, but maybe it's still really not well written yet. Maybe it's still a little bit too general for us. So another technique that I like to use is to utilize the target URL. Now this is really important because with the target URL, what the system can do, what SEO GPT can do is take your target URL and analyze it in order to write a better description or write better content. This could be for any of the 200 plus content types. Putting in a target URL that is relevant is going to matter. So the question then is, what's a relevant target URL? So what you want to avoid is putting in anything here that's like google.com or bing.com or facebook.com. Those are too general. And I'm going to show you a technique on what you can do to find more specific content. For example, if you already have a website with the content on it, then you can use that website, or a specific page from that website would be ideal. If you don't, if you need to do some research, this is how you can do it. So I'm going to head over here to google.com. I'm going to take our keyword. I'm just going to put it in here and just do a search and just try to see what comes up. So my keyword in this instance, or my key phrase, is effective techniques for children's books. And then I'm going to look at some of these first search results to see what comes up. If you get a lot of results that are, let's say, from social media or even YouTube, if you're getting a lot of results that seem like they are they don't have a lot of good written content, you may want to avoid those. What you want to go for is something that's more of a written content, like for example this self-publishing school piece. Let's take a look at that. And what you can do is you can then use this as your reference source. So that's exactly what we're going to do. So we're going to take that and we're going to put it in here as our target URL, and then we're going to tell it to write it once more. So now it's written it, and we can continue to write it again. If we don't like what it's written, we can have it rewrite it. But another thing that's really important here is what to provide for the brand. So imagine if this content is going to go on a website of yours, and this is going to be content that's going to be branded for your company or for your business, then what you want to do is you want to provide a brand if you want it to be a little bit more specific towards it. So in this case, we're just going to, just as an example, we're going to use this self-publishing school as an example. So we're going to do self-publishing school over here. And we're going to tell it to write it. Okay, so you can see that now the system understands that not only do you have a brand, but what the URL is about, and also what the key phrase is going to be about. The amount of information that you're providing it now is a whole lot more specific and a whole lot more in order to help it to generate better content. Thanks so much for watching, folks. And if you have any questions about SEO GPT, just feel free to ask us at any time.